Welcome to the Pixel Berry Choices Podcast. Today we're going to be talking about Chapter 16 of Laws of Attraction. That is the Book 1 finale. And we're going to review it. We're going to talk about it. And there's Book 2 that's confirmed. And we somewhat know what this Book 2 is going to be about. And we're going to talk about it. But just before we dive right into that, I do want to just say something that I recently just hit on YouTube. 150 plus subscribers at the moment, as of now when I'm recording this, it's 153. So that's just I'm really grateful that, like, that is super awesome. Like, I couldn't have hoped for this to happen. Like, what, you know, like, just you guys are super amazing, and it's the best people I can ask for. And just not in terms of subscribers I'm talking about this, but like I always say, just the way you guys communicate and we communicate, it's like super awesome. I like, I do appreciate the subscribe, you know, definitely, but I more than that, I appreciate your comments and also, you know, like informing about, you know, updates and just talking about different things and choices and different theories and just having just fun, joking, and going above and beyond, sharing information. I mean, this is just super awesome. I mean, definitely, it's like a second family to me, and I do really appreciate you, and thanks for that, and I hope that we will keep talking in the comments and wherever we can, and grateful for that. Just wanted to share that. Anyway, so let's dive right into the review of the finale. So we have come to know about Sadie's behavior and how Sadie has literally snaked on us and betrayed us and sold her soul to Kyong, that chemical guy, you know, a big corporation guy. So what we have here, we know with Bo and Aslin in a diamond scene, we can talk strategy, how to confront Sadie and what strategy to bring. Like, we can say either we can be like coy with her, or we can be upfront, or we can bring the class act or the murder mystery. So Bo will suggest that you bring the murder mystery. And then there will be in the moot court room, there will be a big thing. A lot of people will be there. I thought only it's run, the Magro Brine is run by Magro, but there's also one Ellie Brine. And I think we saw them for the first time. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments, but yeah. So this was interesting. And Linda and Reggie, two other who are also sort of big names in this, and their decision matters. So definitely we need to sway them in our favor, and we get to dress the part. Before that, we can go to Aslin or Gabe, and we can get some little support. And then we will lay down the facts in the moot courtroom, and everybody will be shocked. Sadie will eventually try to defend it, and but she will fail. And then we will need to sway some of those high-ranked folks into our favor. And if we do that, then Sadie will be forced to resign. Everybody will be voting aye in favor of that Sadie resigns. And then Sadie will be furious on us, but Bo will defend our main character and will be walking out of the room and being angry on his aunt Sadie. And Sadie will look really disappointed, and then she will resign. Here the story ends. And then later we just go. We also know the partnership contest, and they show us an exclusive, like, sort of the list, and we see our main character is number one, and we see Martin is number two. What I don't understand is, how can Martin be number two? I mean, what did he do? I mean, beside this whole murder mystery case, even when everyone was on board, I don't think he did a lot of good things. I mean, it was mainly Aslin, our main character, and then Bo. Yeah, he could have been ahead of Gigi, because that was acceptable. But Martin at number two, I couldn't get that, how that happened. But anyway, we get to celebrate this. And then we sort of watch on TV on a big screen that this Kyung is being arrested by, you know, the police, and media is there asking him questions. And on the other side, we see Marcus, who's outside of the police station, and he's been set free because we have Aliana's mobile phone, and Aliana did all the work. She had all the details in her mobile phone. So that was quite interesting. And Marcus also meets Kyung face to face and expresses his anger on him. And then he was set free. And there was a line, I remember, two guys standing face to face, one who was wrongly accused of a murder, and another one who actually committed the murder or something. That said everything. And then we come back, we get at a diamond scene too. We go to the bar, we have some fun. We see Martin losing his cool and going away from the bar. And then we get a big diamond scene. One last moment. I mean, this is a classic Choices diamond scene, you know. Like at the end chapter, you get a 30 diamond romance scene. So I took this time with Aslin, and we go to our apartment, and it was a good scene. And then we come back the next day. We see the partnership, and Bo says, we are the partnership competition, we have won it. But surprise, surprise, Martin starts clapping. Like, there was like clap, 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 clap. And we see Martin is standing there. So what he did, he did some shenanigans. And that is basically, after Sadie resigned, he did something, and he got all the other senior partners vote on the fact that Martin made Sadie sign a NDA and some, you know, giving her money and stuff, so Sadie won't be bugging us anymore. And that's how, so as he confirmed this, that the Magro brand won't get under fire for Sadie's deed. So sort of he confirmed it, so that's why he's now the new ruler of Magro brand. And well, Bo is definitely, first of all, surprised and then angry. And it's a genuine anger from Martin. But it looks like that's where it ends. That Martin, so it's sort of going downhill. And Martin is going to rule this thing. So Sadie's out. Look, Sadie was wrong at the end moment. But throughout the book, Sadie's supported us quite well, I would say. But now, Martin, like, I don't know how to, you know, like, he's probably going to be an antagonist character in book 2, and that's all. Alright, so that's pretty much it. We will find out what happens with book 2 later when Choices say something. So some things I would like to mention here. So this is, let me know, how did you feel about, I mean, the Kyung guy who is the main villain. I mean, yeah, there was like a big murder mystery, and we dig it. And then we also call Alejandro. I mean, I call Alejandro. You have also the option to call Elijah, that kid. But I call Alejandro, and we talk with him. And sort of, so that was a great mystery when we went to Alejandro's farm and talked with him and his family. So that's that. But I think I felt like Kyung is a big guy. And we never really went face to face with Kyung. I did hope that Kyung would be the villain, like he would get away somehow, and he would be the main antagonist in book 2, and this will continue. And somehow Sadie may be getting away, both of them like teaming up and then coming after us, something like that. That would have been super awesome, because the way it goes from now, the murder mystery is solved. Okay, murder mystery is solved. So book 2, it's not gonna be about murder mystery anymore. Alright, let that sink in. Book 2 is not going to be about murder mystery. I mean, yeah, of course, there could be another murder, but that the dark murder they said, it ends here. So I kind of personally feel like, we did have a lot of Kyung, but I think there should have been more face-to-face encounters with Kyung. You know, like, he's the big guy, right? I mean, don't you think, like, he got arrested? I mean, his game was ended rather quite, you know, I mean, quite, I mean, yeah, we did a lot of work, but it was mainly exposing Sadie. We exposed Kyung. So we didn't have, you know what I mean? Like, a much more effect on the story by the villain, on our main character and stuff. So I think I would have been glad to see that, and also would have been glad to see, you know, in the sequel, like Kyong getting more power and more damage power, so to speak. But yeah, it is what it is. Definitely one of the best books it has turned out to be. I mean, since it came back from the book break, and newly releasing book, one of the best of this year for sure. So that's it. Book two is gonna be office politics and drama in the Magrobrine law office in there. That's all it's gonna be about. Let me know how it goes, and let's talk in the comment section below. All right, so see you in the next video. Till then, peace out.